begin with the dangers of tsunamis in the spotlight this coming week as a statewide push to better prepare people for a potential natural disaster. The Santa Cruz Harbor is one spot that knows from experience how vulnerable it is. That's where we find Action News reporter Margot Dunphy live in Santa Cruz with more.
Tom, it was here in Santa Cruz that saw the most damage from the 2011 tsunami. And now this is one area that will soon be armed with high-tech maps that will track and identify potential dangerous situations before they happen.
It was like a wave that rolled right through the harbor and lifted boats up to like 3 feet.
Many locals recall the tsunami that hit Santa Cruz after the earthquake in Japan. And now 3 years on, warning signs serve as a reminder about the vulnerability of our coastline.
Everybody's much more aware that of what can happen after the first one coming through.
In the last tsunami back in 2011, it was here at Santa Cruz's North Harbor that felt the most impact, particularly here at the U Dock, which was almost completely destroyed.
When the tsunami hit and actually took out these other docks in front of us, our ship actually saved this dock.
Skipper Jim Bosso and his crew of Sea Scouts saw that damage firsthand. Their boat, the SS Steves, was hit hard, but miraculously spared due to its size and position on the dock.
Luckily, our bow was facing out the coast, so then we were able to ride the waves a lot better than most boats.
So that's what this is all about today.
Bosso says that experience has led him to emphasize lessons on how to prepare for this type of emergency when training his young crew.
The main thing we talk about in tsunami is actually boating safety and to making sure that things are secure on inboard as well as outboard.
Important lessons that, along with new scientific data, will help California better plan for when the next devastating wave hits.
I think it's important that we should know like where the most dangerous areas would be hit.
And Tsunami Preparedness Week this year coincides with the 50th anniversary of the 1964 Alaska earthquake. Now, that 9.2 quake triggered a tsunami that killed 12 people here in Northern California. Tom?
All right, Margot Dunphy reporting live in Santa Cruz for us. Thanks, Margot. And starting tomorrow, there will be activities throughout the state, including a tsunami communications test on Wednesday. You can find more information on the web at www.tsunami.ca.gov.